Welcome students, let us learn about the networking concepts. In our daily life, we come across different types of networks. Let us understand this concept through some examples. Network of roads, railway lines, canals, etc. Communication network of telephone system which enables us to talk to anyone, anywhere and anytime. Network of banks or ATMs, automated teller machines. Radio or television network broadcasts programs live across the globe. Video conferencing is a network that allows discussions between people at far-off places. Network of malls, schools, hospitals, etc. all over the country. Internet is an outcome of cyber networking. Imagine life without networking.
No phone, no television, no internet, etc.
It's unbelievable. Okay, note that when two users have simultaneous conversation via internet, it is called conferencing. When this process is supplemented by live video, it is called video conferencing. Networking. A computer network can be defined as a group of computers and other peripheral devices that are linked together for the purpose of sharing data and hardware resources. For example, if one of the computers in a network has a printer attached to it, then all the computers in that network can access the printer and use it to print the documents as shown in the following figure. Where computer A and B in a network can give print commands to printer attached with computer C. The computers in a network can communicate with each other as well as work independently. Each computer in a network is called a node. The computers in a network may be linked through cables, telephone lines, radio waves, or infrared light beams. Let me share an interesting fact about wireless. This is a means of communication that uses low-powered radio waves to transmit data between devices. Wireless networking allows networks to be deployed without cabling. Spaces such as outdoor areas where cables cannot be put can have wireless network. Now let's discuss the advantages of networking. Networking in computers brings efficiency, economy, and effectiveness in any organization. The first advantage is efficient use of storage media. It is better to store a shareable application data on a network drive than to store a copy of the application on each user's storage device. It is better to have one big hard disk in the server than to have small hard disk in different computers. The next advantage is preserving information. It is difficult to maintain regular backups on a number of standalone computers. When you keep backups on a central location, you have one place to look for the lost information. Another advantage of networking in the reduction is hardware cost. In a network, the hardware devices which are not used very often, like modems, printers, scanners, CD writers, etc., can be shared. This reduces the cost of hardware. One more advantage of networking is efficiency. In a network, the deletion, modification, or upgradation of the software or data is to be done at a single point only. This brings more efficiency and effectiveness into working system. Another advantage is redundancy. A network reduces the need for hard copies of all documents. By sharing files over the network, the need to share proper copies of reports or any other information can be eliminated or greatly reduced. Networking delivers document the quickest way. Internet provides a facility to instantly deliver soft copies from one computer to other computers throughout the world. Students, what is this? This is the Bluetooth logo. Bluetooth is a wireless technology used to interconnect mobile phones, computers, and printers using short-range wireless connection. For more information, visit www.bluetooth.com. Network components. To establish wired networking in a group of computers, we require the following additional components: network card, networking cable and hubs and switches. It is used to physically attach a computer to a network so that it can participate in network communication. Ethernet network card is the most commonly used network card. Nowadays, most of the computers' motherboards come with the inbuilt network card. Networking cable. Modern Ethernet networks are twisted pair cables containing 8 wires. These wires are arranged in a special order and an RJ45 connector similar to but bigger than the connector used with the telephone wire is crimped at both the ends of the cable. Hubs and switches. Network cards are used to send and receive data being transmitted over Ethernet cables. When a network has more than 2 computers, we cannot directly connect all the computers together. We need an interface through which the computers can be connected and sending and receiving of data can take place. This function is performed by a hub or a switch. Hubs are the preferred medium in earlier times, but now switches are being used because of their better efficiency. A hub or switch performs the following functions. Acts as a central point of connection for all the computers on a network. Every computer plugs into the hub or switch. To arrange the ports in such a way so that if a PC transmits data, the data is sent over the other computer through its network card. Basically, the hub or switch is a box with a set of RJ45 ports. Each computer on a network is connected to the hub or switch via an Ethernet cable. Okay, let me tell you that Wi-Fi stands for Wireless Fidelity. It represents wireless local area network. It was developed for mobile computer devices like laptops, but is now used in PCs, video games, consoles, smartphones, tablets to exchange data wirelessly over the computer networks. To establish wireless networking, we require the following components. Wireless network cards are used instead of the normal network cards which are being used in the wired networks. Most of the laptop computers come with the inbuilt wireless network cards. Ethernet cable is not required as radio signals are used for transferring data. Access points or routers instead of hubs or switches. These have a wireless antenna which increases the communication range of the radio signals. Access points can also be used to join a wired network, thus making the network a combination of wired as well as a wireless network. WAP, Wireless Access Point, is a device that connects wireless communication devices to form a wireless network. Alright, let us now learn about the types of networks. There are various types of networks which are used worldwide these days. Depending on the geographical area covered by a network, there are 3 types of computer networks. Local area network, that is LAN. In LAN, 2 or more computers and peripheral devices are connected within a small area, such as room, office building or a campus. In LAN, computer terminals are physically connected with wires. The data transmission speed is slow as compared to WAN. Since LAN is operated in a small area, so it can be controlled and administered by a single person or organization. Metropolitan Area Network, MAN. MAN is a larger network than LAN. It is spread across a city. Since it covers a city, it is called metropolitan. The most common example of MAN type network is cable television, branches of local bank in a city, etc. Wide Area Network, WAN. This kind of network connects 2 or more computers located at faraway places. They are linked by communication facilities like telecommunication or satellite signals. The most common example of WAN type network is telecom system. The usage of fan is limited to very large organizations and government agencies. The main characteristic of fan is that it requires a public telecommunication media to transfer data. The best examples of fan are internet and intranet in a large multinational company. ATM facility is the result of fan. Multinational bank customer services. Now let us talk about the network architecture. Network architecture is an overall design of a computer network that describes how a computer network is configured and what strategies are being used. Computer networks are of two main types, client-server network and peer-to-peer network. The client-server network is a network where several computers called clients or workstations are connected to the main computer called the server. A server is a computer that provides services to clients and controls access to hardware, software, and other resources. Clients are the computers which request services like data retrieval, storage, etc. from the server. Peer-to-peer network. Peer-to-peer is a network where a few computers having equal capacity and capabilities are connected together to use the resources available on the network. In peer-to-peer network, there is no central server. Each computer can act as a server as well as client. Students, let me tell you more. The protocol defines a common set of rules and signals that computers on the network use to communicate. One of the most popular LAN protocol is called Ethernet. All right, students, let me now tell you how to access a file from the shared drive. Double-click the network icon on the desktop. A list of shared drives are displayed in the view pane. Click on the required shared drive to see its contents in the view pane. Find the required file in the drive. If you want to open the file, double-click on it. To copy the file, right-click on it and select the copy option from the shortcut menu. In the folder pane, select computer icon to view the storage drives on your computer. Now click on the drive where you want to place the copied file. Right-click on the view pane and select the paste option. The file will be copied into the selected drive on your computer. Network security. The most important aspect in computer networking is data security. Since many users are accessing the same data, so we must ensure its proper security. Only authorized persons can access or modify data. Consider the following points that may happen in any organization. Some employees may try to change the data concerning their leave record, salaries, performance, appraisals, etc. Accidental deletion of important data. Former employees or some other people may try to harm the company's data. People outside the company may try to access confidential data. Network security means protecting data and resources from access by unauthorized persons. There are two general levels of network security. Login security. You are given a unique login name and password. Rights security. Based upon your username, you are given rights like read-only access or read-write access or no access at all. A combination of rights can also be granted to the same user for different sets of data. Let us quickly glance through the key points discussed in this chapter. In a network, two or more computers can communicate with each other and share data and peripheral devices. Networking in computers brings efficiency, economy, and effectiveness in any organization. We can send messages at a very fast speed over long distances using satellite and microwaves. LAN, MAN, and WAN are the types of networks. Computer networks are of two main types, peer-to-peer and client-server. A server is a computer that provides services to clients. In peer-to-peer network, there is no central server. Instead, each computer can act as a server and a client as well.